right? Oradell, New Jersey. Steam boiler removal and replacement. We're crying already. We're taking out a big Peerless. It's oversized for this house. So we're gonna put in a 138 crown. Actually gonna stub out for a baseboard loop later on for the basement because there's no heat in the basement and it's always freezing.
A keeper. Yes. Put it in the skin box, please.
New crown steam boiler ready to go in right now. Frankie, what do you think of crown boilers? Easy to work on, easy to install? No? No. So, the old boiler kind of sitting in the middle of this walkway right here, blocking a whole bunch of stuff. So we're gonna take the new crown, set it off into this little cubby, and we're moving the 2-inch over above it. We're gonna take the return lines, drop them down into the Hartford loop return. We're moving the gas line. That'll fit nicely, give them a lot more room in this basement. And here's our main header, just about in. I'm trying to really condense everything here, so steam connections, they're going to be real tight. It's going to be tough to get in, but once it's all in, it's going to look really nice and clean. Okay, we are up and running for tonight. A lot of things are just dummied in for today. But other than that, we have no leaks. It's running, it's cooking. So they're gonna have heat for the next couple of days just fine. We're back on the steam boiler job. We're gonna finish this guy up. We're gonna secure the vent. I'm gonna put a cleaning agent in this guy so through the rest of the season, it's gonna clean the pipes, clean the radiators. Start pulling all that soot down to its block, and then we're gonna flush it out at the beginning of next season. Max is upstairs right now replacing the radiator valves on a couple leaky radiators. Boiler's in, up and running. We've been running for about 4 days now. It hasn't been adding any water. We've checked the relief valves. We've changed a couple radiator stops. And here we are, another successful install.